Again, hello, Kostis. Nice to see you here again in lovely Greece and Athens. Yes, it was much better than expected, I have to say, because meanwhile the team made it to get contracts with, for instance, the top 8 insurances out of the top 10 ones. So I think the market share for the insurances that do work electronically is almost 80%. I think that's a pretty good achievement, much more than we would have liked to or thought it would be possible within that short time frame.
What do you expect from the Greek branch?
Well, a lot. I know they're very powerful, have a wonderful relationship to the customers and do deliver what they promise in front of customers. So what we are focusing on next is all the insurances that do not yet work with a system for their claims handling process. So I think there are quite a lot of insurances that still work manually and are convinced they know all the data off the top of their head, which cannot be the case given the complexity of the vehicle and also the claims handling situation. So the team goes after these insurances to convince them, to help them get into a technical solution step by step, not to put everything into one system or do everything at once, but to have good reasonable steps to start developing into a digital world.
You have a global view of the group, so you probably know more than us. What is the new things that is coming out? What is the new trends? And if you can give us some hints.
So you asked me for the crystal ball. Well, there are some trends going on in the market, and we have discussed this with some insurances today already. More and more we see these, the smartphone, the self-services to start pretty early with the digital process is surely something that would be new to the market here in Greece, which is something that is commonly used in the other markets. More and more we see these artificial intelligence to have a photo in front of you of a damaged car and then to do the first enter of a damage based on photo and image processing with the artificial intelligence engine behind. And that's something we, of course, in China, we have had a lot of discussions. We are ready to prepare on the deep learning tools and the software, the algorithms to identify damaged zones of a car, to also identify the spare parts that are damaged. And also with the knowledge that we always know at that stage the precise vehicle and the precise material, because just having the photo alone does not really help you, because you have to know what material is it to come to a good severity index for how reliable the engine is when it comes to a first estimate. The system tells all instantly, this is the damage, this is what I can do as a intelligent, can I do automatically, and these parts are parts I am very, very sure are damaged, this is the repair we would do, and these parts please double check. So this is more for these assessors to have a better quality when reviewing a damaged car. Of course, there are some use cases where you think, oh, maybe there's then behind of it an automated process. And we do have insurances where we do this on a daily basis, and up to 30% of the damages that come in automatically are okay. So they, of course, this is then an automated process. But it depends on the use case, how to embrace technology and changes and new ideas. So, and I'm sure that's also something that comes to Greece, I would say rather sooner than later, because it can be, as I said, a help to the assessors to do the work better.
One trend globally is the fully automated driverless cars. Is this something that is concerned the insurance companies globally and your business?
Well, we have already these data for it and business processes. Currently, more in the underwriting area, because you have to better know how the car is equipped. What are the options? Are there any ADS systems in it that help maybe reduce some damages or damage costs? Damage costs usually go up with these systems. This is very interesting. I would not think this gonna hit our reality very soon. because the systems are in a stage. Just look at Tesla, for instance. But in the next 5 years, also you have to build the infrastructure. 5, maybe 10 years more and more, you're going to see it. What we are working on is on these early calls out of the vehicle, using whatever connected data drives from whatever manufacturers, but also from other devices, so that we get very early information on what happened to the car when there was an accident. And to get not only the data, because this is the one stuff, but the most important thing, in our opinion, is to have to get the touch point with your customer at that stage, and not to lose your customer, because as the manufacturers do want to come up with the connected data, and they want to keep the control on the customer, so they can get it and then they steer it. And if they have the first touch point, and they can do not only steering it to repair shops, but maybe doing something else. So what we do, not only the technology, not only to have a first entrance of these digital files, but also we're going to help support our customers to get these touch points back.